This is all wrong.
Dear Greta, we agree with you. In fact, we think you should be home, studying, listening to music, playing with your friends, enjoying your family.
I shouldn't be up here. I should be back in school, on the other side of the ocean.
Dear Greta, from your words, we understand you've been forced to do what you're doing. This is all wrong, as you've said. This is like you were kidnapped by the people who wanted you up there. I suspect these persons are your parents, your parents' friends, your mentors. You really should first ask them the question why you are there and not on the other side of the ocean in your country.
How dare you?
The passion and the emphasis you put in these words either are not healthy or you are a really great actress born to be in a theater. In both cases, the only persons responsible for you and your childhood are your parents. Therefore, cry out, how dare you, to them first.
You have stolen my dreams and my childhood with your empty words.
Their words are empty, and everything you are going to say here. But they haven't stolen neither your dreams nor your childhood. This is all your parents' fault. In the very moment you are speaking, there are people suffering. That's true. But the children of your age, in your country, and in similar, rich countries, are still dreaming, and they do not go around the world, pointing the finger against people who can't be directly responsible for their childhood. They can be happy. You can be happy, at home, with your family, if only this family had decided that you can find your role in the world, in this way, and helping them becoming richer, in the process.
Yet, I'm one of the lucky ones. People are suffering. People are dying. Entire ecosystems are collapsing. We are in the beginning of a mass extinction.
Dear Greta, I don't know who told you that we are at the beginning of a mass extinction. If you truly believe that, I can understand now that your rage is driven by fear. I want to reassure you and your followers about this. There's no such a beginning. Humankind will be extinct somewhere in the future, and there's nothing we can do about it. Life on this planet will find a way, though.
How dare you continue to look away?
Dear Greta, who are you talking to? We are the first responsible for this situation. We are the reason why they, the people I suppose you are talking to, were able to build a fortune. Our lifestyle made the world as it is. What can regulators actually do? Very little. Ask your friends, your followers, everyone to stop watching TV, to stop begging for a new smartphone, a new computer, a faster internet connection, an easeful way to move from point A to point B. Ask everyone to stop wasting resources, to create things that don't last and that aren't really useful for life. But you first must ask people if they are ready to stop desiring those things. I can assure you, it won't work. And that's why you are a mean, for a purpose, which isn't in favor of the vast majority of women and men, but of the very few rich persons you are pretending to talk to. The people looking away, that's us, and in particular your generation, manipulated in order to find the scapegoat in the previous, older generations, to avoid to look in the mirror and find out that you are the gears spinning to make this machine work as it does.
They also rely on my generation sucking hundreds of billions of tons of your CO2 out of the air with technologies that barely exist.
My generation, she says. Your CO2, she says. Dear Greta, that's your generation and your CO2. It's created because of you, not in spite of you. Once you understand this, you will also understand that you've been an instrument of the power, not a challenger of the people in charge. Then if you really believe in this battle, you will learn to blame your parents, and you will tell them, how dared you? But more likely, your fame will make you rich and assure you a good future. You will still talk about climate change, maybe aware that you are changing nothing. But you won't care, because, well, you've found your place in this world.
How dare you pretend that this can be solved with just business as usual and some technical solutions?
Dear Greta, the non-technical solution would be this. Your generation must refuse most of the technology which makes our rich countries rich and powerful. No more television, no more smartphones, no more food from another place in the planet, no more Google, no more Amazon, no more eBay, no more movements of goods all around the globe, no more vacation in other countries, no more planes, less cars, yes, less cars, not more efficient cars, it would be a nonsense, and less people. We need to decrease the number of people on the earth. Can your generation accept all this? Is it ready to live as humans lived a century ago?
We will not let you get away with this.
Dear Greta, the fact that you are there, and the things you were allowed to do, promoted by the very same persons you pretend to despise, are the proof that they are already getting away with it.
The world is waking up.
On the contrary, the citizens of the rich, modern Western countries were never more sedated than they are in this historical moment. Thanks also to the ability of the power to foster revolutionary acts like yours as a tool to control the masses. That's how the ruling elites of the rich, peaceful countries tame the democratic beast nowadays, giving hopes and illusions of control and power to the average persons, promoting heroes, so to speak, who fight against injustice to make the world a better place for the meek.
Thanks for watching.